Ende Fahndern, Ende Fahndern.
In die Fonda takes great pleasure in welcoming author, professor, blogger and columnist Professor Debanjan Banerjee to throw some light on the indie film revolution.
Independent filmmaking is not a very new concept, it is a very old concept. First, we need to understand what exactly independent filmmaking is. Basically, one filmmaking is inside the studio and one filmmaking is outside the studio. Basically, the independent filmmakers think the real definition of independent filmmaking, you have to go outside the studio, because in studio or inside the studio there are some constraints. You have to do something, you have to abide by the rules and regulations. But being an independent filmmaker, if you go outside the studio, you can choose the subject, you can shoot as per your wish, as well as your technicalities, your content, it's completely run by yourself. But nowadays the concept is changing, and even inside the studios, some of the independent film directors or the filmmakers feel that as such there is no interference inside the studios also. So in a country like India and any other developing countries, independent filmmakers are indispensable. They are making many wonderful films on diversified subject of social interest and come with a solution, different social solutions. The films like Crossing Bridge, you must be knowing, it's one of the best independent filmmaking. Tashir Desh, Else A Little Poland in India, Cosmic Sex or Court, these are the milestone independent filmmaking in our country. So independent filmmakers are ultimately serving the society in different way, and I think the days are coming when many of the young media professionals and the professionals coming from other streams also will be interested in independent filmmaking, and these films will play a very crucial role to mitigate different social problems.
20 years experience in media industry and media academics, Professor Debanjan Banerjee has already authored 2 books for media graduates, postgraduate students and media professionals.
The most challenging part for an independent filmmaker to arrange money from the producers. In many cases, if the budget is 35 to 40 lakhs, it is very difficult to earn money. In Indian situations, it is called the crowdfunding. In many a case, we find there is a crowdfunding, right? So I can give you an example. Recent example is, in the 1980s, there was a film of Nasiruddin Shah, Albert Pinto Ko Gussa Kyu Aata Hai. So this film is being remaked by, right now, Soumitra Ranade. So according to Soumitra Ranade, he had to struggle a lot while arranging money for his film. The film is being acted by Saurav Shukla Nandita Das. So ultimately, he managed to convince one particular internet website, Wishberry. And Wishberry practically sponsored his film and they gave 35 lakhs. But the problem for the Indian independent filmmakers, that to generate revenue, to convince a producer that these films will definitely give return on investment. Because the producers or the money investors feel that these films may be a very good film, but they cannot earn more money for the businessmen. But there are some interesting websites nowadays are coming up, like Catapult, Wishberry, Kickstarter, Kato, Indiegogo. These are the websites, they are funding films. I could remember two films more precisely. One is Punya Koti, and Sanskrit animation film. It was sponsored and funded by one leading crowdfunding organizations. Another example, it's a very interesting example I can give you, Shyam Benegal's Manthan. Shyam Benegal took money from the farmers and made the films. So in many cases, you'll be finding crowdfunding is the only source for independent filmmakers in our country. Apart from these sites, websites, Wishberry, Kickstarter, Kato, Indiegogo, they sometimes fund it. But really, it is a problematic part from the filmmaker's point of view to convince the producers.
He is also the head examiner and board of studies member, Media Science, of Maulana Abul Kalam Azad University of Technology. He is also paper setter moderator, external examiner, syllabus committee member of the media departments of leading Indian universities.
It can be a profession, but the problem is to make it popularized economically is still a challenge for the independent filmmakers. So they have to go for the crowdfunding. Now definitely YouTube is there, they can upload their films, there will be lots of views, likes. From these likes, definitely they can generate some revenue out of the advertisements. But still it's in the struggling phase. The potentiality of the independent filmmakers, I have no doubt there are many brilliant independent filmmakers are there in our country. But the problem is the money part. Hopefully the producers, the sensible businessmen will come up and help this independent filmmaker to make wonderful films. And if they help these creative people, definitely these creative people will also give them return on investment. And that will be a win-win situation for both the filmmakers, as well as it can become a very viable profession in the future course of time, and even for the business point of view.
Being a prolific writer, Professor Banerjee contributes for leading newspapers, magazines and web portals on current affairs, media and management subjects.
My piece of advice for the independent filmmakers are, first of all, they have to choose the right subject. There are many problems are there in the society, even the documentary filmmakers are making this, but the independent filmmakers have to find out the apt subject. That subject will be very catchy, and there is a problem in the society. If there is a problem, the independent filmmakers have to come up such content and try to give a solution with the help of their film, number one. Number two, they can be technically sound because their resources are less, so they need to utilize their resources with optimum utilization, by which they have to have a very sound technician also, right? Third part is creative way. They have to be a very sound person, because in independent filmmaking there is less glamour, maybe you are unable to shoot more, there may be less outdoors even in some cases, there are many other constraints. So you have to come up with genuine creativity with a best technical expertise, plus overall your concept of the film, because the concept is very important, because ultimately you need to penetrate your audience, your viewers, and ultimately you are working from different challenges. And the problematic part is many people, even the producers and the businessmen, they don't promote independent films. So you have to come up with one of the best ever topic, its execution, which includes the content, creativity and the technicalities. And the last thing I can say, try to make the film as lucid as possible, because if your film language is too difficult to understand, it will never become popular, because most of the independent filmmakers are practically coming up with the movies or the films which are basically dealing with the mass. So your topic should be lucid, your presentation should be lucid, but definitely have an immense impact over the viewers.
Indie Funder heartily thanks Professor Debanjan Banerjee for his enlightening views and expert comments. Thank you, sir.